from the campus of Westfield State University. This is 89.5 FM, WSKB, Westfield.
Support for the community programming of WSKB is provided by Westfield Bank. For more than 160 years, Westfield Bank has been an important community presence and commercial leader in the Pioneer Valley. With convenient full banking services in Westfield, West Springfield, East Longmeadow, Agawam, Feeding Hills, Springfield, Southwick, as well as Enfield and Granby, Connecticut, visit us on the web at westfieldbank.org. We thank the generosity of our underwriters. For more information, please contact the Westfield State Foundation at 413-572-8646.
Morning. Hey, we didn't have our theme because I realized it's 6:07. There there were five people in line ahead of me at 5:45 at the Dunkin' Donuts. No excuses.
I just want to let you know that was Candy Dulfer, and the song was Lily Was Here. That was a hit in the late 80s, early 90s.
I remember that well.
And she is a rockin' sax player.
Don't think I ever knew that. Who did the song? I recognize the song, and it's just one of those things. Oh, yeah, great background tunes. You know, it's
this was on the top 40?
Yeah, it was a number. Yeah. I think it was a number one.
Oh, wow.
And for the record, Bob, thank you for the coffee. We appreciate you waiting in that long line. And for the record, any boss that I know ain't going to take that for an excuse.
Yeah, nah, they're not.
You're late.
Yeah. But the idea here is... I was thinking about how we get angry. You put somebody in a car and you give them an appointment. This is the problem with Americans. We immediately get angry at people who are just living their lives like you and I. So I'm angry at the four people in front of me. Then I get up to the line and I know Tiffany at the counter. It's not that, remember the old...
Yeah, we know. Don't worry about it.
So at any rate, now I get calmed down and then I'm in line and then I'm behind a truck. And I'm getting angry at the truck in front of me who's going the speed limit. And just because he's going the speed limit, I'm getting angry because I want him to go for the way I go. And I realized that this is what's wrong with America.
So, Bob, how does that make you feel?
Thank you, Doctor. I would say that it makes me feel confused because it still doesn't get rid of my anger. It just I say, oh, there's anger, which is a good thing. If you're a therapist, if you are able to recognize the name you're feeling, then you're on the way to getting rid of it. But my stomach is still churning. How dare those five people stand in line in front of me
now
at the Dunkin'
Donuts?
You know what,
though?
The
mayor was saying this on his show last week. Honestly, a 10-minute difference in your daily routine, like getting on the roads, makes so much difference in traffic and everything else.
Oh, it does, especially this time in the morning.
Even he said that last week because he was coming out from the north side. He said, I left 10 minutes later. Watch out, your cap, you're not closed, Bob.
I'm closed.
The other side's not closed. I watched
every part of me is dripping. All right, there we are.
He said that 10-minute difference can make all the, and I noticed that even coming in here, a 10-minute difference is amazing how much more the traffic
that's
or less
exactly
the traffic
right.
Is.
Which is why I've always told my kids growing up, it's better to be 10 minutes early than 2 minutes late.
You're right. And I've lived that rule in reverse my entire 73 years.
George Carlin, when describing crazy drivers on the road,
yes,
said something to the effect of, to the guy that's rushing to get through the red light, why didn't you just leave 30 seconds earlier?
Oh, yeah. Oh, I think about that all the time. But I can tell you why I didn't leave 30 seconds earlier is because I stayed 3 minutes longer because I was reading the list of Grammy Award winners the other night.
Whammers.
And I got it all timed down. Like, I get out of bed at 5:15. Today I got out of bed at 5:18. But there was a snag in the planning. So I thought I cut my shower short. I did cut my shower short. Then I realized, oh, my God. I am now in charge of the dog's food. He's supposed to be fed at 7. I'm on 6 o'clock time now, so I needed to feed the dog. And that meant cutting up the meat, putting the cheese in, and I ignored...
Who trained who?
I know. So, quite honestly, it's my darn fault. And I'm accepting the anger and the blame, and I'm saying, wow, it's Tuesday, and it is February 12th. It's Abraham Lincoln's birthday, and to be honest, I love being here on Abraham Lincoln's birthday, even though I've had a little sleep. And JPEG, Luca, Trusty, Dusty, Lusty, Musty, Crusty, and Well-Modulated Sidekick. And they
well-modulated and 10 minutes early.
Yeah, right, and 10 minutes early. And the very early, very, very, very comic book-like character of a hero, the fabulous Fireball of February, that is Pete Coles.
And, Fireball.
Fireball.
I got to pull that clip for the rest of the month.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, did you find the Fireball of February? Is that a name of a...
No,
a,
there's a song called Fireball by Pitbull.
Oh, there is.
Where he says, Fireball.
Oh.
It's Fireball. It's an instrumental. Just, that's the only lyric.
And,
oh,
that's and pretty much, yeah, well, there's a few lyrics, but not much. Well,
we don't know what he actually shouts. He's a bald white guy who just bounces around on stage.
Maybe somebody just gave him a wedgie and he just made it, you know. Oh.
Now that you think that I think about it, that is what it looks like.
At any rate. So, look, the day today is very interesting because of what happened. As you know, Jay, you won't believe it, Peter. There must be some kind of like star in the sky. Your friend Carrie, right on
her
way.
There's a whole lot of stars.
What happened to her?
What do you mean? Oh, she slipped and fell and broke her ankle.
Yes. Okay.
And then James broke his ankles probably around the same time.
James, last week. Last Tuesday, right after I left here.
Yep.
Remember in the middle of last week's show, I got a call from Noble Hospital, and I was saying, what do the doctors want now, et cetera? And
it was him.
It was James in the emergency room. He had fallen. Now, if you're going to...
Somebody said they were walking... He was walking over to see somebody, and he broke his ankle.
He was walking to see... He was going to Leo's for breakfast. Supposedly.
Right, to meet up with somebody.
To meet up with Dennis Akins or something.
That's right. Denny said that. Okay, yep.
Yeah. And he was passing First and Adams Funeral Home, and he fell in front of the funeral home. This sounds terrible. It's really so ironic. So then okay. So Joanne.
Well, that
Taylor,
same day, Ralph Figge fell coming in here, and he fell on that one patch of ice there, right by the parking lot. He fell coming in here. He didn't break anything, but he fell too.
Oh well, James broke his foot in two places. Okay, so then we...
Well, see, that was the confusing part. Somebody said he broke both feet in one place, so it's actually broke one foot in two places.
His tibia, see how rumors get started. Yeah. So you know what this means. So we go to Noble Hospital. They took good care of us in the emergency room.
And then we
went off to Bay State Noble. And then we went. We made an appointment with my sister's New England Orthopedics and met the doctor. Now James is in his glory because the doctor is wearing cowboy boots. And I'm in my glory. I know. And he's 14 feet tall, and he's wearing cowboy boots. He's from Kentucky.
Go find Save a Horse.
Yeah. So,
that's too cliche.
Yeah. So then I find out Dr. Tom McDonald, his name is, very nice, solid name. He went to Holy Cross, graduated 25 years ago last year. So we are...
youngster.
Yeah.
A veritable youngster.
Well, what's the irony of this whole thing, or the synchronicity of it? I am 50 years out. He is 25 years out. In fact, so I'm 51 years out of Holy Cross. He's 25 years out. And there he is taking care of James. All right. Now, the story doesn't end there. All right.
I had no doubt that it was going to.
Yeah. So then he proceeds to tell us that we need to have an operation. James is going to have little, what do you call it, feet, little iron things put in. What
pins.
Do you call it?
Pins. Rods, pins.
Pins, and there's
screws.
A plate going in there and all that crap. And
Rods and cones are in your eyes.
Oh, that's right.
Okay.
So... we then get assigned a time for our surgery, which was yesterday. All right. Now, ask me if the surgery happened.
Did the surgery happen, Bob?
No.
Oh.
We got up. I got up. I had to be there first.
That's because you weren't 10 minutes early.
No.
You didn't make it on time?
Oh, around health issues and around James, I got to be on time because he'll be in the car. He'll drive himself, even with one foot. To the emergency. So I was up at 6:30 yesterday morning in order to get him to the emergency room, or not to the emergency.
The hospital.
To the surgical center, yes, for 7:45. Well, at 8:15, James announces that he has had a little bit of the scone that I cooked, the scones that I made this week. So they all go, "You ate?" He said, "I know. I put it in my mouth. I took 3 bites. I swallowed some, and then I threw the rest out because they said, 'What am I doing? I'm not supposed to eat.'"
Too late.
All right. So consequently, they sent us home.
Yeah, because they can't do anesthesia with a full stomach.
That's right, because apparently the food aspirates up.
You could, yes, because they're pumping your inside full of gas. So
yeah,
and you could choke on your thing, die. Yeah,
that's now, you could have chosen to forego the anesthesia.
Thank you, doctor. Thank you, Dr. Frankenstein. Yeah. No.
No.
So then we have to do the walk of shame. You know how you walk into the surgery center and you're all like nervous and everything, and then they came in and they said, "Well, you can leave whenever you want to leave, without anything." They didn't have to give us anything. We just had to leave and then call to make another appointment.
Take 2 aspirin and call me.
Oh, God. So we do the walk of shame down this beautiful surgery center on Wasson Avenue in Springfield. And all the nurses are going, "God, now remember, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera." And I'm furious at James for making a mistake. You know, just like I said, you get angry at other people for what.
Bob, you have serious anger issues.
I don't have any serious anger. No.
Yes, you do. You're getting people make mistakes.
Oh, I know. But I'm 73 years old. I deserve to have a little.
At your age, you should be all mellow and fruit and pies and flowers.
That's right. Don't get in line with me at the Dunkin' Donuts. And don't forget to take, do not eat food.
Carrie says she feels James' pain and she hopes she feels better.
All right, okay.
I have a prescription waiting for you in Northampton.
What is it?
Right off the highway.
A straitjacket, no doubt.
You might have to wait a little bit in line.
Yeah, what is it? Oh, marijuana! Mellow yellow.
They call me mellow yellow.
So let me tell you about the upshot of this entire episode.
Please don't sing, Pete.
No, the upshot of this whole thing is I have now...
not that bad. Yeah, you heard me singing.
Yeah, you're not bad. But the three of us are pretty good.
I'm not as good as you.
Thank you. I was looking for that compliment.
Yeah, I know.
No, you were fishing.
I was fishing for a compliment. So look... this is the upshot of the whole thing.
Yes.
He's going to be operated on tomorrow morning. Okay? So, hopefully.
Go there tonight.
Don't feed him.
We might go there tonight. Yeah. So, I've got 3 days that I'm getting up really early in the morning. Poor me. Then, get this. 6 weeks, he has to remain off of the foot. Totally off of the foot. So they have this kind of machine where you kneel on the machine. It's not a machine. It's like a bicycle or whatever. And we could get that. The problem is my house is designed so that it doesn't work in my house because there are too many levels and too many uneven floors and the spaces are too small because the house was built in 1760. So consequently, he's on crutches and he's immobile. For 6 weeks.
So he'll catch up on his reading and TV viewing.
Mm-hmm. And I will catch up on getting the water, getting the pills, cooking, taking care of the dog, walking the dog, doing all the things.
So you're going to lose about 15 pounds then.
I'm going to be wonderful. And, you know, I really get it about being a caretaker. I love James, and I will do anything for him.
Yep.
And I will continue to do that, and without any kind of, like...
Reservations.
Or stuff. But something in me says that 6 weeks seems like a very long time. And...
That's because you got ADD, Bob.
Yeah, I know. And I have to... So, at any rate, yesterday I made the scones that James did.
All right,
I made pea soup this week.
All the friends of Bob, check on Bob occasionally to make sure he's not gone stir crazy.
Oh, God help me. So, then we have another 6 weeks after that he has to put light weight on it.
Physical therapy.
We can't go anywhere or leave the house for 3 months, basically.
Well, Bob, you need to schedule a vacation for the terminus of that time.
Yeah, I'm working on it right now. Okay. Believe me.
You'll have time to do that.
Oh, yeah. I've got really a lot of time to do that.
So when am I coming over to fix your printer so you can start work from home?
That's right. Oh, my God. That's
God,
that's,
man.
Yes, all right. So after James...
Watch this. I bet you it's one cord.
After James's operation tomorrow... Perhaps next week.
Yes, yeah,
you'll be
in,
invited.
Yes.
All right, wouldn't that be nice?
I'll take my lunch break over there. Fix it in 20 minutes.
Good, oh, that's great. Okay, why don't we do that?
Okay,
that'll be a there'll be a star in the East. James is James. Peter Cole's The Fireball of February will be appearing at my house. Hey,
got that
6:22. It's going to rain. No, it's not.
No,
gonna.
It's going to start as snow.
Yeah,
snow. Very heavily this afternoon during the afternoon commute, then change to rain and then freezing rain, then or sleet, freezing rain, and then rain, and end about 1 or 2 o'clock in the morning.
All right, so those of you who are
early dismissal for schools
are
today.
Snowplow and snowblower aficionados.
Yeah,
all right. This is New England, right? So
yes.
You know it's going to snow.
Mm.
Now this is going to be a good piece of snow, a good little snowfall. A good little snowfall?
A good little snowfall.
A good amount of snow falling upon your driveway. Now, don't run out and shovel it all right away or snowblow it all right away. Let the freezing rain create a crust on the top. Now, when you go out with your snowblower or your shovel, you're not chipping ice off a driveway. What you're doing is you just go out with the snowplow, and it'll toss everything right off to the side, and you don't need to worry about salting the driveway. By tomorrow noon, it'll be clear and wet.
And beautiful.
Yes.
How do you like that? Oh, Jay, what a nice thing to do for
everyone.
You know
how you learn that?
How do you? By experience.
By experience, yes. And you learn to be lazy. I don't have to rush out and plow the snow. Wait and wait.
Yeah, yeah.
And be patient.
Yeah.
And don't get angry.
No.
So how does that make you feel, Bob?
Well, I kind of like snow, so I'm kind of looking forward to this. And I feel badly for all the folks who are going to have to travel, but because of where we are, and because I'm the Florence Nightingale of Nine West Silver, I am going to be in the house until we leave for the surgery tomorrow morning. So, yeah. Yeah.
We need to get Bob a traditional nurse's hat.
Yeah. That's a good idea.
So this afternoon,
here's the prescription.
Yes, when
you sit in your living room, open the window, watch the snow fall, and open a very nice bottle of Chardonnay.
No, it won't be Chardonnay. It will be a red wine because I drink red wine.
Cabernet?
No, it's going to be a Merlot that I have already opened.
Nothing better than a Merlot that's had a chance to breathe.
God, it's been breathing for a week.
I actually have a cranberry red wine in my fridge.
Oh, that sounds terrific, too. Hey, everybody, it's 6:25. We've got to play a song. Better song? Hey, Albert Finney, one of my favorite actors of all time, died last week. We are so sorry about that. And he starred in my favorite movie of all times. And somebody recommended it on the news the other day, saying, you want to know about a marriage. You want to know how everything works in a marriage. See this movie starring Audrey Hepburn and a very beautiful and young Albert Finney. It's called Two for the Road. It happens to be James and my song because I lured him into my relationship with him in Italy by singing this song as we walked along the Arno. Yeah, I know it sounds romantic, everybody. So it's Two for the Road. This happens to be George Shearing singing a song. Usually he plays, but he accompanies himself on the piano. It's from a Carmen McRae album. She doesn't sing on the song. It's George Shearing, and it is Two for the Road.
If you're feeling fancy free, come wander through the world with me. And any place we chance to be will be our rendezvous. Two for the road, travel through the years, collecting precious memories, selecting souvenirs, and living life the way we please. In summertime, the sun will shine. In winter, we'll drink summer wine. And every day that you are mine will be a lovely day. As long as love still wears a smile, I know that we'll be two for the road. That's a long, long while. Summertime, the sun will shine. In winter, we'll drink summer wine. And every day that you are mine will be a lovely day. As long as love still wears the smile, I know that we'll be two for the road. And that's a long, long while.
Support for the community programming of WSKB is provided by Comcast and Xfinity.com, offering Xfinity TV, internet, home phone, and home security services. Information on all that Xfinity has to offer in the Westfield area is available online at Xfinity.com.
One of our underwriters here at WSKB's Community Radio is Carson Center for Health and Human Services, a nonprofit organization located at 20 Broad Street in Westfield. They provided behavioral health and rehabilitation services in communities throughout Western Massachusetts since 1963. There are services for children, adolescents, adults, families, and couples. You can find them on the web at carsoncenter.org or at 413-572-4133.
We thank the generosity of our underwriters. For more information, please contact the Westfield State Foundation at 413-572-8646. Wednesday mornings start off right from 6 to 8 a.m. with Tina Gorman and Wake Up Wednesday.
Community Radio,
89.5 WSKB.
Live from the campus of Westfield State University, this is 89.5 FM, WSKB, Westfield.
Wow, it's Tuesday morning. It is February 12th, Abraham Lincoln's birthday today. Oh, play this, Peter. Go ahead. We're not going to, So this is the big hit song by
whom? Mr. Worldwide to infinity. You know the roof on fire. We go boogie, oogie, oogie, jiggle, wiggle, and dance like the roof on fire. We go drink drinks and take shots until we fall out.
Oh, this is great. Who is this?
Now, baby, get my booty naked, take off all your clothes and light the roof on fire. Tell him, baby, 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 I'm on fire.
Oh, yeah. Baby, Hans, come on.
Baby, 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 I'm a fireball.
Oh, God.
So there's your fireball.
That's Peter Coles is the Fireball of February, the fabulous Fireball of February.
So you're going to pull that little piece out of there. Yeah, that's going to be where you're going to be your intro now every morning.
Fireball. Fireball. So last week I judged the spelling bee, and that was really a lot of fun for the Kiwanis at the Circle K. And oh my God, these children at the fourth grade level,
they spell better than me.
Oh
yeah,
my
it's true.
Gosh, unbelievable.
I still spell potato with an E.
Oh,
just like Al Gore.
Oh my God. So what was one of the ones? Here, try recommend.
It wasn't Al Gore, though. Well, who was it? It was.
You never know how many C's and M's to put in recommend. Don't go there.
Who was the vice president that couldn't? It wasn't Al Gore.
It was Dan Quayle.
Dan Quayle, right.
Couldn't spell potato.
Recommend.
Recommend. Spell recommend.
S-U-G-G-E-S-T.
Spell recommend.
R-E-C.
You have to say the word before you spell it.
Recommend.
Okay, there we go.
R-E-C-O-M-E-N-D.
O-M-E-N-D. Totally wrong.
What do you mean?
R-E-C. R-E-C-O-M-E-N-D.
It's E-N-D.
Oh, E-N-D. R-E... All right, Jay, try it.
S-U-G-G-E-S-T. And that's my story, and I'm sticking to
all right.
it.
It's R-E-C...
I missed an M.
C.
I told you, I never get the right number of M's and C's in it.
No, I know it. I'm always going. It's at recommend, if you think about it. So it's R-E-C-O-M-M-E-N-D.
Yes.
Recommend.
I missed an M.
Both of us spelled it wrong.
I was debating on my head whether it was two or one.
Yeah.
I was in a writing class some years ago, a business writing class.
Yeah.
And we were talking about the, you know, when you can't spell something and you can't figure it out, you look for a synonym for it and use that word instead.
Oh, yes.
And there's a term for that. There's a term for, and I can't remember.
It's avoidance.
Avoidance. That's but, yeah, there's actually an official term for that, is looking for a synonym because you can't figure out how to spell the first one you want to use.
I've done that, too, though. I've done that.
We've all done it, but now you know there's a term for it. I just don't know what the
term
is.
Well, there must be. Is there a term for when you can't remember what the word is and you're looking for the word, and so because you can't remember what the word is, you can't even remember what a synonym is. So you're trying to avoid saying, pick up the glass container over there.
Find a thesaurus.
Yeah. Oh.
A thesaurus.
Carry a thesaurus wherever you are.
Yes. Or just have a computer. We're all spoiled now. I'll pull up the phone and just, you know, type in what you're trying to say.
It'll Google come it. Up with,
yeah.
But don't depend on the phone to spell it correctly for you.
Spell checker's horrible.
On the phone. Oh, my God.
Damn, autocorrect?
Yeah, real. Autocorrect. It's gotten me in more trouble. Honest to God.
That's not spell check. That's autocorrect, and it's a very different application.
Oh, is it?
Yes.
Oh. But if they...
Don't confuse
the two. Autocheck and spell check are two different things.
No.
So it's my...
Yeah, autocorrect is what it thinks you're trying to say.
Oh.
So here's the other rule of thumb when you're writing for business or anything else for that matter.
Right.
Always read what you've written before you hit send. Always.
Yeah, because every time I
write,
if I put plas in, it always comes out asshole. Honest to God, really. Oh, am I allowed to say, is that one of the words I'm not supposed to say?
If you're writing it into the Jerusalem on a holy day.
I was talking about the word itself, actually. So I think we're safe, right?
Too late now. Don't call attention. Don't call attention to your mistakes. No one ever notices.
Yeah, yeah.
Another word.
Yeah.
Why do they call it rule of thumb?
The rule of thumb.
Where did that come from?
Now, that's a really interesting question. What is the rule of thumb? The rule of thumb is the regular procedure, right? Oh, I got it. Here. But you put your thumb up like this. Here. Look, I'm doing it for you.
No, that means that they ain't going to kill you in the Colosseum.
Oh, yeah. But I'm putting my thumb up, and that says, yes, you're right.
It could mean
no, could
correct.
That be it?
It could mean, yeah.
But of so there must be some kind of procedure called thumb. All right, here we go.
The expression rule of thumb, it has its origin in carpentry.
Carpentry.
When the thumb was used as a makeshift measuring device.
Ah.
So how many thumbs long is it? That literally was early days of carpentry before rulers.
So a thumb is like an inch across.
Okay.
So you put it one,
maybe
two,
your thumb,
three. My thumb is like an inch across. My foot is a foot. My foot is 12
kind
inches.
Kind of.
Yeah, yeah.
It truly is?
No, yeah. I have a foot. Yeah. Unless that's shrunk too. I'm not sure.
We all kind of change shape as we age. Yeah.
That's
all right.
True.
But I don't get it. So if the rule of thumb, Peter, comes from carpentry because they use the thumb as an indicator for measurement.
Okay, I'll buy that.
The phrase rule of thumb is used to describe a useful principle that has a wide application. It means like, you know, okay, that's rule of thumb. Generally.
Generally accepted.
But it's not necessarily reliable in all situations.
Oh. Oh, I didn't know that last part.
Yeah.
Because the rule of thumb may be, I get it, because not everything aligns. Nothing's perfect in this world. Is that what we're saying?
You should open the door before you go through the opening. That's a good rule of thumb. Now, doesn't have to be that way. What if
I don't get that? Wait a minute. You could open the door.
You want to see what's on the other side, Bob?
All right, but what you said, you have to go through the door. No, wait a minute.
You should open the door before you go through the opening.
So you always need to know what's on the other side.
Well, no, you don't want to break your nose because if you don't open the door, you'll run into it. Now, that's a good rule of thumb, but it doesn't have to happen. What if it's a pair of swinging doors at a bar?
Oh, right?
They kind of open for you.
Yeah,
what if it's a door at the supermarket? Yeah. It opens for you.
Yeah.
Oh, come on.
Or an elevator that has
come. What do you think, this is a game show?
The elevator door opened on that show. Remember that woman fell down right into the elevator shaft because she walked? That's
right.
How they
just
got
rid of it.
Just
because the elevator door opens, don't walk into it. Make sure the elevator's there.
All right. Good rule of thumb.
Good rule of thumb, Jay.
All right, let's play a song. Hey, 6:40 in the morning. Did you find my Dua Lipa song by chance?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Two lips?
So
what?
Get this. The Grammys happened.
No, she's a Spanish singer, right?
Yeah. Hispanic. No, well, she might. Yeah, Latino, but she is Latina. But no, she's an English woman. She's from England.
Is she really?
Yes. And she used to put her stuff on YouTube, her songs on YouTube, and now has been listed as the best new artist. Now, for the last 4 weeks, I've been playing...
Last year?
No, the Grammys this year. Remember, I played...
I was hoping Greta Van Street would win.
Yeah, Greta
Van Street. They're a really good band.
Oh, I know that.
I mean, they're excellent.
Greta Van Fleet.
That's right.
Greta Van Street, yeah. I played. I played Margot Price... And I played Luke, whatever his name is, Luke Charles or something like that. Okay, so all four of the people that I played lost.
Okay.
Dua Lipa.
So now you got the winner.
This is the winner, and I'm going to play her.
You saved the best for last.
One Kiss.
No.
Yep. So listen, let's see if she deserves to win. It's called One Kiss by Dua Lipa, and she's the new artist we're going to hear all about. All right, here we go.
Still out. all you need.
Support for the community programming of WSKB is provided by the Barnes & Noble College Bookstore in the Ely Campus Center, offering Westfield State t-shirts, sweatshirts, and gift merchandise, all of your academic needs, and offering textbook materials in new, used, ebook, and rental formats. Available at the bookstore on campus or online at westfieldstate.bncollege.com.
We thank the generosity of our underwriters. For more information, please contact the Westfield State Foundation at 413-572-8646. Discussions of local politics, events, happenings, and miscellany potpourri. Ken's Den, Tuesday, 8 to 10.
Live from the campus of Westfield State University, this is 89.5 FM, WSKB, Westfield.
Wow, it is Tuesday morning. It is Abraham Lincoln's birthday, February 12th. This used to be a national holiday. When I went to school, we got February 12th.
Lincoln's birthday, but then they consolidated him into President's Day.
Oh,
which I believe is,
who's the other president?
Isn't it
like, George Washington?
That's isn't it like
right. February 22nd?
Next Monday is the President's
Day? Next Monday,
Day?
I think, is President's Day, and most school systems have that week off.
Yes.
Oh, that's right.
And then municipalities, I think, have the day off.
But why did I think that this was the vacation week for kids? It's not.
In Connecticut, I think it is. In Massachusetts, it's next week.
It's next week. Yes. Okay. All righty. Well, it doesn't affect me. I'll be just walking the dog, cooking, cleaning, and playing. You know, no more of that sitting
James has
here.
Finally domesticated you.
I have been domesticated.
I think I'm going to go buy James a little tiny bell. So every time he needs something, like, ding, 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 ding.
A little pair of walkie-talkies. FRS walkie-talkies. Yeah, so wherever Bob is, you know, he'll be...
Well, I've learned. I'm combining everything, you guys. You know what I'm doing?
Walkie-talkies don't take as long.
Yeah. Bop. Here, I'm combining. You know,
there's also a little alarm you can set off on the thing.
Oh, stop the two of you. All right. Cardio. You know my cardio thing. I'm still doing my cardio. But now, because of this, I've combined my cardio with the walk, with the dog walk. So I'm now walking fast, and I've got over my embarrassment about marching in place. I just don't face the road.
I had my partner dispatching walks, gets his steps in, and he was walking around the room, and then he's walking down the hall, just doing big laps.
Right.
Getting his steps
sure.
in.
Sure. So you got one of those Fitbits.
Fitbit thingy, yeah.
Oh, yeah, I'm going to get them.
All you got to you put it on your arm, right?
Yeah,
all you
got to
do is, right, and how does it count how many steps you're doing?
How does it tell you what your heart rate? No.
I think it does it the swing of your heart.
It tells you your blood pressure as well.
Yeah, it measures all kinds of things just by touching you. That's one thing. But how does it know when you take a step?
Because there's movement, I suppose.
Swing of your arm.
You're swinging your arm. That's correct. So,
if you don't swing your arm?
Right. If you don't swing your arm, it's not going to go, you know, you're going anywhere. And conversely, you can sit on your butt in your chair and just swing your arm, and the thing thinks you're going, you know, walking across.
It's also nice to have weights in your hands, though, when you're doing stuff like that. You're walking the dog, so it's different.
Well, then you only have one weight in one hand, and you're going to have one Popeye arm.
You know, I do both.
You know what? You know, so. I had this experience yesterday walking the dog that was really kind of surreal. You know, I always love Christmas music, but the bells downtown began to ring in the church.
Bells
and you know, they play in the afternoon music. And so we walked all around the green while Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer played.
This time of year?
Yeah, yeah.
Really?
And then we had sleigh ride.
Somebody needs to adjust the tunes.
Somebody has got the wrong... I don't think it's a person in there playing. I think they have
it's a program.
Now, it's a program.
But here's something that most people, especially downtown people, don't know.
Right.
And you know, the old burial grounds, which is off of Mechanic Street,
when you're
in there, and I do this every fall to help out with the ghost tours.
Right.
But when you're in there, it's very quiet. You don't hear the traffic around you.
Mm.
But what you do hear is all of the bells from all of the churches around downtown.
Mm.
So it's the coolest thing to be working in there, very quiet, doing your thing, and then all of a sudden the bells start going off. And you remember, think back 300 years ago, that's how the town announced something. That was the alarm for the town, were the church bells. Depending on how the bells were
rung. So what were they announcing yesterday with Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer playing?
It's going to be cold and your nose will be red.
Ah, and then they played Sleigh Ride, so it's going to snow.
It's going to snow. That's the weather report.
Oh, okay.
See, we're on track here. Maybe it all makes sense.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, so 6:49 in the morning, we're going to have snow today. Now, Jay and Peter,
here's
a thing. I'm on this pitch to make sure that people are shopping during the winter in the downtown area.
Okay.
All right. So every one of the stores. Now, I was wondering, could you, if I gave you a certain block, could you tell me what stores are in it from this block to that block?
Possibly.
All right. Let's go store to store. What's next door?
Possibly.
What do I win?
I'll buy you coffee next Tuesday. Yeah, I got out of that one really. Yeah. All right. So let's start on the side of the street that the Athenaeum is on.
Okay.
And we're going to start at School Street, and you're going to go from School to Arnold Street.
Why start there? United Bank.
Yeah. Okay. Start at United Bank.
There is a hair salon.
Uh-huh. It used to be a Wilder's. I don't know what the name
There's
of it is.
There's a Circuit Coffee.
You're missing a store in between.
No.
Yes,
there's a hair salon. And there was a realtor in there? Might be a realtor in there.
I think, was it Edward Jones is in there?
Could be. I know it's a realtor. I know what business
Okay.
I don't know the exact names, but I know what.
Cross School Street then.
Cross School Street is Fast Feet.
Uh-huh.
And then there is the... But they're upstairs. The Christian Lutheran Church Service, Children's Service.
All right, I'll accept that. But what's now next?
Next. I can picture it. Puffer's Printing is down there.
Oh, great. Okay. Wait a minute. Puffer's Printing.
They might be first.
Puffer's Printing is first.
They're in that first building.
And Fast Feet.
Santander Bank.
Santander Bank.
Santander.
Dare.
I believe that's how you say it.
Yeah, all right.
And then after that is Rosewood.
Rosewood.
Then there's Two Rivers. Mama Cakes.
Mm-hmm.
What's after that? There's a little shop there. Is that the end of the block and then it's empty? There's the walkway.
No, there's something before the walkway.
Then it must be a professional office.
It's a realty
realtor.
Okay,
it's
so
Park
professional
Square.
Office.
Park Square Realtor.
All right.
Then there's the Church Commons.
Yep, there's a Church Commons, which has the kind of, I can't remember the name of the business, but it's kind of
Blended
like a...
Blended Vintage.
Okay, so
Blended
it's
Blended Vintage
right.
Marketplace. Very, very...
There's
funny.
Barbers in the back down there along that block if you go down the alleyway.
Uh-huh.
Then there's the open lot.
Newberry's.
Right.
What was Newberry's?
Newberry's was
a
discounter.
J.J.'s Newberry's.
It was a 5 and 10 cents.
Discounter.
It was one of the last, 5 and 10. It was one of the last in a 5 and 10 store, a small variety store.
Yeah. Had,
not food variety, but what we
More like an Ocean State job lot.
Into a department store.
Mm. Like an Ocean State job lot.
Yeah. 5 and 10. I bet there are kids that don't know what a 5 and 10 is.
Go to a Dollar General.
Five and
That's
ten
what a 5 and 10
now.
Is.
Oh, was Dollar General a 5 and 10?
Yeah, pretty much, yeah.
Oh, I had no idea. I thought it was a hardware store.
No, it's like a general merchandise
it's
like store.
I thought they sold insurance.
that's the General.
Dollar General is not even on. It's on North Road. It's a new store on North
Southampton
Road.
Southampton Road. It's right across the street from my house.
Oh, wow. Okay, so.
Very convenient.
Yeah, very nice. We are now on Arnold Street. So what's Arnold to the Franklin Street?
Westfield Gas and Electric.
G&E.
Cash Insurance.
Okay. Yep.
What's next?
Ooh, there's that. It's a.
Another professional office?
Yeah.
Another realtor,
yeah,
I think.
It's got some kind of, I don't know what they do. They're in there doing some work.
Oh, it's going to be the new IT place.
No. There's another. No.
They're occupying the
is
upper
it
floors.
Something Max? Something Max?
Not, oh, Remax.
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 Right.
All right. Then there's the old.
The old Piccolo's.
The old Piccolo's, which is being renovated.
Right. The old Pickle Barrel.
Okay. Yeah.
Then there is Skyline Trading.
Yep.
And then
No. Skyline Trading is not next to Piccolo's. It's not next to that.
No, there's a door. There's a door to allow you.
Oh, it's at Alo Saigon.
No, that's afterwards.
Oh my
yeah,
God!
Yeah, it's afterwards.
This is a really hard exercise.
It's a good. Oh point. My! Well, somewhere in there, you got Whip City Music. You got somewhere going up there. Where's the new Yummy Noodle place?
That's down where the original. It's right Nepalese market was.
Yeah, it's right next to the community church on the corner of Franklin. Rocklocks. Is Rocklocks
that's right
Rock
on the
Locks
corner.
Is right on the corner.
On the corner. So
community
it's
church
Rock
is
Locks,
before
community
that.
Church.
That's Jerry.
Westfield Bank has a training center in there.
Oh, that's right. There is that massage place.
Yep.
What's that?
Optimum Health.
That's further down.
No, that's in the beginning of that block.
Oh, there's a Chinese restaurant. Isn't there a dance academy there? Oh, yes, yeah, responsible driving there.
Yes, that's there now, where the dance academy was.
Oh my God! I don't think have we left anything out? Westfield Bank Training Center. There's a law office. There's Robert Walker Law Offices. Oh man! But
so let's before we bore everyone. To
yeah,
death,
no.
You also forgot Shenanigans Bar.
Oh my God! Forgot
Mike's Barber Shop. Law offices of Robert Walker.
Right. Yeah.
Now he's got it up on the computer because all of a sudden he remembered that. Oh, Google Maps.
Yeah. Isn't that interesting?
I want to see if we missed anything actually.
But if you really think about it. That was only one side of the street. We'll do the other at another time.
There's a lot of stuff there. Yeah. I was going to ask, what was the point of that exercise?
I want everyone to know that there's stuff to do in downtown Westfield, and you can go to the bookstore.
You're right. Alo Saigon, Health, Skyline, and Westfield Music.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, yeah.
So yeah, I mean, Noodles isn't there yet.
There's tons of stuff, and that's on just one side of the street.
It is an old picture, yeah.
Yeah. So at any rate, that's my plea, everybody. Get out there and shop in downtown during this long, hard winter
I'm
month.
I'm going to go find out how yummy they are.
Yeah, yeah.
I've heard they're really good.
Let's play at 6:56 in the morning. It's going to be snowy. Then it's going to be icy and sleety, and then it's going to rain.
Just let it snow.
Okay, so we're not going to shovel our sidewalks until the crust.
Let it get crusty.
Until
it stops, because it's going to stay below freezing.
Thank you, Mr. Crusty Psychic.
That's why they call me Crusty.
Yeah, and that was well modulated. Very good. Very good, Jay. Hey, so today is the Abraham Lincoln's birthday, as I said. And so, to be honest, I went through all of his songs and stuff, and I came up with Louis Armstrong's version of Battle Hymn of the Republic. And this is a great jazz tune. It has a feel of New Orleans as well. And the Battle Hymn of the Republic will always be associated with Abraham Lincoln. This is a great version of it. Louis Armstrong, an old, old recording, Battle Hymn of the Republic.
Thank you.
Support for the community programming of WSKB is provided by Bay State Dental. Comprehensive dentistry at 14 convenient locations in Springfield, Chicopee, Longmeadow, West Springfield, Belchertown, East Longmeadow, Ludlow, Northampton, Greenfield, and Wilbraham, as well as 29 Broad Street in Westfield. Bay State Dental makes it a priority to help you achieve and maintain the healthy smile you deserve. On the web at baystatedental.com.
We thank the generosity of our underwriters. For more information, please contact the Westfield State Foundation at 413-572-8646.
Discussions of local politics, events, happenings, and miscellany potpourri. That's what you'll find on Ken's Den, Tuesdays from 8 till 10.
Live from the campus of Westfield State University, this is 89.5 FM, WSKB, Westfield.
Wow. You caught me unawares. Is the word that you caught me unawares?
I believe that's correct.
Or unaware. You caught me unaware.
You just did a spelling bee. You should know these things.
I know it. Unawares.
I believe it's
unawares.
Hold on a second, Doc. I can hook you up.
Yes, yeah. Would you spell doctor?
D-O-C. T-O-R.
Dr. Kevin Coughlin, everyone.
That's why we get along speller. So well, because speller. we got the same sick sense of humor.
Spell recommend for us, doctor.
R-E-C-C-O-M-M-E-N-D. Recommend.
Too many C's.
Too many C's.
D-D. One C.
One C, R-E-C- two M's. I screwed it up, too. I missed
Did I say two?
Yeah, and if you said two C's and you were in a spelling bee, you'd be out. Because once you say a letter, you'd be out. Every one of us misspelled recommend.
All you have to do now is threaten to sue, and then you're back in.
What if you're in a spelling bee and you stutter?
Ask for S's. I know.
Pronunciation. That's the age. Yeah. That's what they were starting when I started grade school. That was an experiment. Yes. Well, you sounded words out and spelled them the way they sounded. That's the way I was taught.
Uh-huh.
And I've been handicapped ever since.
Yes.
I blame it on the education.
This
system.
Lovely little girl who was so adorable. She was sitting I judged the spelling bee, Doc, the other night. So she was sitting on her chair. And kind of cross-legged, and she went, oh my God, I think she could have had her own television show. And she was so adorable, and she got the word circumstance, and she went, S. Oh, no. And because she was sounding out the word, and she said the word S, she was disqualified. Aww. I was so saddened by that.
Heartless.
But so, if you spelled circumstance... The
it's
way
not the word I thought you
it
were
would
going.
Be, right. It would be S-I-R-C-C-O-M-E, stance. S-T-A-N-T-S. A-N-T-S.
Well, that's...
See, that's a proof that you can't make it sound like...
No.
That,
no. Right? Yeah. Didn't they call that whole educational experiment...
This was wrong?
Well, I mean, that's the way they I remember the first spelling bee, first
yeah.
grade.
Yeah.
Mrs. Zulon was my teacher. That's how much it... And the word was supercalifragilistic... expialidocious. So that was the word we all had to spell. If we didn't spell it correctly,
that happens to be one that is spelled just like it
yes,
sounds.
Yes, it is.
Yes,
supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. That was really
26 letters.
Yeah,
in that
pretty.
Word.
Yes, and that.
And what movie was that from? Bob.
Well, I know what this is.
Mary Poppins.
Of course.
Yeah. He's an artist. Of course he knows that.
And in fact, it's not even a word. They made up that word. Richard Sherman, and they made up, Richard and Robert Sherman made up that word for the movie version. Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. P.J. Travers, who wrote the Mary Poppins books, couldn't figure it out because she was really angry. If you want to see a great movie, it's that Saving Mr. Banks about the guys who wrote Mary Poppins. And Tom Hanks plays Walt Disney in it. And Emma Thompson plays P.J. Travers, who wrote Mary Poppins. It's a really great movie, Saving Mr. Banks. It doesn't show, there's only one time when Tom Hanks takes a cigarette and puts it out. Because they didn't want Walt Disney everybody to know that our favorite star, Walt, our uncle
was a chain smoker.
Yes, exactly right. Well, at any rate, hey everybody, guess who's here? It is the doctor of the hour, the
man
Duke
in
of
black
dentistry,
say and, more.
Yes,
keep going.
Yeah, Dr. Kevin Coughlin. Dr. Kevin Coughlin is from Ascent Dental. I was going to say Ascent Dental Supply.
Services.
Service. Yes. Service
Ascent
care.
Dental services.
Yes. Better care, better service, better results.
Nice tagline. I like better. It.
Yes.
Yeah.
Isn't that?
Yeah.
I don't know. That sounds like a ripoff from Papa John's.
It is. Nothing I ever say is original. But no, I'm honest about it.
You spell it A-S-C-E-N-T.
Correct.
Okay. Oh, because now that would be a wrong word if we were trying to sound it out.
Yes.
Ascent.
You'd be amazed at the number of people that mispronounce ascent or misspell it. I just thought it was...
How do you mispronounce ascent?
Ascend. They say ascend rather than ascent.
Oh, okay.
Okay. And they'll say, what is the name? And it's Ascent. Actually, three businesses. Ascent Dental Care, which is the dental business. Ascent Dental Solutions, which is a consulting business. And the largest...
And you know what? You also have a proctology service called Ascend.
Yes, yes. It's not...
Bob!
It's not taking off as well as I thought.
It's not.
But you never know.
Here, Bob, let's get you out of that.
Yes, yes.
Oh, God.
There's a cent.
There's a cent.
Right.
Oh, yeah. One penny.
So I just finished up a two-hour presentation at the Yankee Dental Conference in Boston. Approximately 25,000 dentists and dental providers, dental assistants, and
all in one audience there?
Oh no!
They're different.
Yes.
What did you?
Actually had 20 out of the 20,000.
Well, that's good.
But it was a nice conference, a lot of education.
Where they hold it?
They hold it at the Hines the. Boston
Hines Convention Center.
Yes. Oh, it's that big. Oh,
it's huge.
Yeah.
So what was your presentation? My presentation, I was asked to speak on corporations. How are they affecting healthcare? What are the positive things that corporations offer? And what are the negative things that corporations? And basically the gist of it is do consumers, patients, do they want to know who controls their health care?
Oh,
and for some people, they do. And for other people, they don't care. You'd like to think in the real world, your healthcare providers are providing the care and service they believe that is best.
Mm-hmm.
But sometimes corporations have to meet deadlines. Corporations have to meet
quotas,
financial obligations.
Yeah.
And sometimes they have to meet expectations from investors. That doesn't always have to be bad. It can be good.
Yeah.
But the bottom line is should you know that your healthcare is coming from other sources? So that was the gist. It was a 2-hour
presentation. You mean like the management would be, like would it be important for me to know that the management
what
was
culture's running
living in, or was in a distant, in Bangladesh or someplace?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And, like anything, there's positive, there's mm-hmm. negative.
Yeah.
And from my perspective, I think I've seen it probably more than the average healthcare provider.
Well,
certainly
sure.
In this area, I've been involved with it basically since 1983.
Mm-hmm.
And I've seen the pressures put on me as an individual owner. I've seen pressures put on me as a small group, as a large group,
uh-huh.
as part of a corporation. So, you know, it's like anything. There's yeah. good and bad.
Yeah, it's exactly. But I wondered, because when you see something, I mean, like, would you go to buy a hamburger at, let's say, Frank's Hamburger Stand or McDonald's or Five Guys? And would you say, oh, let's go to Frank's Hamburger Stand?
You know what? I think it depends on where you are, because when I'm on the road, when I used to be on the road all the time as a salad truck operator, mm-hmm. you'd pull into a town and you don't really know any of the local places, but you see a chain that you recognize and you know that the food's going to be consistent, you might be opt to stop at the chain.
Right.
If you know the area, like around here,
mm-hmm.
I'd rather get a burger at 9-11 over in Agawam, you know, Feeding Hills, because
yeah.
I know the guys and I know the food is good. But if you don't walk into a town and you don't know what's going on,
you have to go to a chain. That's one of those
things,
I think that's
a great point. You have to understand that these corporations have an enormous amount to lose if they don't maintain high quality control.
Yeah.
So
a consumer might be, would it be good for a consumer to say, are you a local, are you run locally or are you run?
But even then,
it's
branding. So
yeah.
His brand, old brand is Bay State Dental, was well known in the community at branding.
Right.
Now you have to build a new brand, and that's, you know, people know who you are, so that's going to help your brand, right? But then you have to build it from scratch.
I mean, I'm not here to bash corporations.
Oh, no,
I'm just simply here to say to you, what have I done in the last 4 weeks?
Right.
Those presentations, in my opinion, were very well received. But ultimately, I'm talking to healthcare providers. I'm not actually talking to, quote, consumers.
Consumers, right.
And right. My personal opinion, at least in the Western Massachusetts area, my feel is they're more comfortable knowing that the owner is the owner,
mm-hmm.
that the decisions are being made by an owner not hundreds or thousands of miles away. That doesn't mean they're right.
That's a very Yankee thing, though,
right,
too.
Right.
That is a very Yankee
Absolutely.
Thing.
Absolutely. If you go to different areas of the country, they really don't care.
Well, you know, here's the idea.
It's a New England thing.
Let's make it into Frank's Burgers. I know that Frank is buying his burgers in a local store, probably.
Right.
Okay. Whereas McDonald's is at a plant someplace in Albuquerque. Is that right? And everything is sort of
pre-packaged.
Well,
it's all regional distribution.
Yeah,
yeah.
Stay with the McDonald's brand for a minute.
Yeah.
Just because, and I'll pick on that because it was one of the first successfully franchised restaurants.
Yeah.
It was all about consistency. How can I be
right.
exactly the same, whether it's a store here or Albuquerque or Amarillo,
China.
Texas?
Or China.
They might use a slightly different seasoning in China, but it's all about consistency. If I get a burger here, I know that while I'm on the road, I can go to Burlington, Vermont, and find the very same burger there.
Mm.
It may not be what I like, but I know it's the same.
Right.
Now,
right.
When I, this is me, when I'm on the road,
right.
I like variety. I like to look for that Frank's Burgers or whatever. Right, right. I looked for that when I was driving a truck in the 70s. That's what we did, is we looked for that diner, that little, if we found the old railroad car diner on the side of the road and there was a couple of trucks parked behind it, we knew it was a good place.
Exactly. Yeah. That's better advertising.
There,
yeah.
We know it's a good place.
Have you ever gone to a restaurant and you were the only people in the restaurant for like an hour
and it's dinner time.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
I remember. This is funny because it involves Sam Champion. Do you know who Sam Champion is?
No.
You know, guys?
Weathercaster.
He's a weathercaster who was on Good Morning America for years. He's had his face done. He's a handsome, blonde man. Nice man. So, at any rate, I go to
So
I go to the gym, and after the gym, and this is in New York City, down on 6th Avenue. So I go to the gym, and then I go into the coffee shop across the way, and it has like 40 tables, okay? And so I get my coffee, and I notice there's nobody in the place. And that's so I need my coffee and my donut after working out. So I go over to I sit in the center of this restaurant, surrounded by 40 empty tables. Into the place comes Sam Champion, and I'm sipping my coffee, and I look up and I see this famous person. And the famous person looks over at me, and he. And I said, my God, he's recognizing me. Look, he's going to speak to me. And I mean, at that time, I was so taken by anybody that I met. And I was meeting a lot, you know, because I was in show business. I was meeting a lot of people, but I never met Sam Champion. And I thought, maybe he's going to ask me out on a date because he's a gay man. And now, years later, I realize... I was sitting in the. There was a picture. This 40 tables and one person in the middle of the room, sitting drinking his coffee alone in this restaurant, and that's the reason he was staring at me.
Well,
it's all about me.
You never talked. You made no conversation.
I made no conversation. I might have been. I might not have been here. I might have been in New York City. I might have gotten a gig as a weather forecaster because of that. Who knows? You know? Who really knows? I spilled the coffee yet again. Honest to God, I think it's time for a break, everybody. 7:15
so
in the
too.
Morning. Today's Michael McDonald's birthday. Did you know Michael McDonald?
Personally, no.
Yeah. What was he?
Doobie Brothers.
Doobie Brothers.
And then he had a solo career.
And he had a solo career. But he also liked the Traveling Wilburys. Remember the Traveling Wilburys?
I do.
They were made up of...
Supergroup.
Supergroup made up of Bob Dylan and...
Jeff Lynne.
Yeah, and whatever. He had his own... Michael McDonald had his own supergroup made up of Donald Fagen, who was from Steely Dan, right? And Michael... and Van Morrison and Michael McDonald. And it's called the Dukes of September. Did you ever hear of the Dukes of September?
I have not.
No.
Me neither.
So this is the Dukes of September with Michael McDonald, and they did covers and they did their own songs and stuff. Actually, they have a great PBS special you can tune into on YouTube. So the Dukes of September featuring Happy Birthday Boy Michael McDonald, who is now white-haired and in his 60s or 70s. How old is that? I'll have to check
out. One of the most distinct voices out there.
Yeah. So we're going to hear him singing Who's That Girl? It was an Isley Brothers hit. This is the Dukes of September.
Thank you.
Underwriting for WSKB's community radio programming is brought to you in part by R. Levesque Associates. They are offering landscape architecture, civil engineering, environmental permitting, and land surveying. RLA is a second-generation company devoted to excellence in the planning and design of outdoor spaces. On the web at rlaland.com or at 40 School Street in Westfield.
We thank the generosity of our underwriters. For more information, please contact the Westfield State Foundation at 413-572-8646. Friday mornings is something different on 89.5 FM. It's JP's Talk About Town.
Community Radio.
89.5 WSKB.
Live from the campus of Westfield State University. This is 89.5 FM, WSKB, Westfield.
Westfield on weekends. Wow, it's wow. Tuesday, and the Westfield on Weekend show is alive and well. I'm with J. Peg Luca, my trusty, well-modulated psychic, who is the president of Westfield on Weekends, and is there for all of us all the time. We got Pete Coles, the fabulous Fireball of February. Fire, we got fire. The Duke of Dentistry from Ascent Dental Care.
Thank you.
You needed a jingle, right?
Well, I was told if you're going to market, you should have a jingle. And as Pete was stating off air, he said it's a little passé, but because it stands out, maybe it's a good idea.
No, dun, I mean, it was big in the 70s and 80s, and then it went away. But now it you might be on the beginning of the wave.
The cutting edge.
Yes. Here we are. All right. It's the truth. For your tooth, Ascent Dental Care in East Longmeadow. Better care, better service, better results in East Longmeadow. It's the truth. Ascent Dental Care.
Okay, I think the phones are ringing already. The appointments are being made.
What do you think, Doc? See, that was right off the tip of my tongue there.
When you pick up, they say, stop.
Yeah.
Here we go.
Oh, my God. Who the hell cares?
Thank you.
What's your favorite jingle of all time, then, J.Peg Luca? We'll help the Doc here.
I'm going to think on that a little while, because I've got, it's a nostalgia thing. I think when I think jingles that... I think back in the 60s, and you know, those are the things that stick in my mind. You think about that. Bonomo Turkish Taffy had one. Alka-Seltzer, you know, remember Speedy, Alka-Seltzer guy. Yeah.
N-E-S-T-L-E-S, Nestle's makes the very best. Yeah,
there's a good example.
Chocolate.
Yeah, where's it, Pete? Here's a good one. They're not jingles, but they're station IDs. Where's that piece with all the station IDs in one?
The jam song?
Yeah. Find that. There's a good example.
Oh, you know, there must be a song for Pepsodent. Wasn't there a Pepsodent commercial?
I believe
that had a theme song.
Or Good and Plenty. Remember that? Good and Plenty. Good and Plenty.
I said Dental Care. We got to do a hip song. We got to do a hip-hop song.
Yes.
Ascent Dental, better care, better service, better results. No.
Ascent Dental Care was just in a international and national magazine, 10 pages, on one of the best dental offices for design equipment in the world.
Wow.
It was just published 2 weeks ago. That was one of the reasons I spoke at the Yankee. Patterson Dental Company and Henry Schein are the two largest dental supply companies in the world. Huh. And they put me in their magazine, which comes out four times a year and goes to, I believe, 160 countries.
So here
Wow.
So here they came in, they filmed it, they used one of those 3D cameras. They interviewed me for about 2 hours.
In 3D, you're in 3D.
Well, I had never seen this before, but a
gentleman walked in. The new 3D style camera, yeah.
And it just goes 360 degrees around, and that...
Like a drone?
It's got four sides to it, and they walk around with it on a monopole.
Right.
Yeah.
And actually, if you go to ascentdentalcare.com, there's these little icons, and you can get a virtual tour. But that was filmed with this four. Yes, I had never seen the camera. Yeah. I didn't even know how it operated. But they took out all the stops because I think, like I said, it went to 160 different countries.
Yeah,
just in the United States alone, I think there's over 200,000 active practicing dentists. Each dental office gets a copy of it. So it was a flattering article. Basically what it was is, what can you do with technology but not isolate the patient? Sometimes you can overwhelm people with technology, but you lose the personal care.
Yeah. No, that's right. It. I would much rather have the person with them, a good machine, but because the person, regardless, is the person that's going to put their hands in my mouth.
In my consulting business, when I talk to young men and women entering the field, which I'm actually doing next week, the first thing I tell them is, don't put the equipment before the patient. The patient still, in my eyes, still wants that connection to their healthcare provider. As I call it, BLT. They want to believe you, they want to trust you, and they want to like you.
Right, right.
Once you establish that BLT, you've improved the odds of success.
So here's
And that's personal branding.
That's, in my opinion,
personal
that
branding
always trumps technology. Yep. Now, when I see the younger...
Coupled with technology, it's a home run.
Right. When I see the younger men and women come into the practice, they almost expect the technology because they see it every day in their life. So I don't know if that will hold true 10 and 15 years from now. You know, when I see my own three children, young adults, actually not children, they're selecting through technology. In other words, they're on their cell phone, they're making their appointment.
Right.
Who's convenient, who's not. They're price shopping. What's the Yelp review? What's the Google review? They're using technology to use a decision. And then when they walk in, I think they expect the highest level of technology that's available.
Yep.
That's my opinion. When I see older people, they want to know who you are. They want a little conversation. Mm-hmm. And I'm generalizing, obviously.
No, you're absolutely right here.
No, I think I agree with Bob. I think you're right. That's a generational thing.
Well, because, get this. James had a doctor this week who was working. His name is Tom McDonald. And I mentioned his name to several people. And they said, oh, I know Tom McDonald, the doctor with the cowboy boots.
I got the cowboy boots comment from three people. And the doctor with the cowboy boots, oh, he's great. Oh, he's a dreamboat. Oh, whatever. But it was the doctor with the cowboy boots.
There's
and isn't that an interest? Isn't that really interesting? The what you wear, I suppose, even has a thing.
It's
I
mean, a total like, package from the entrance into a facility to the exit from the facility to the team members that support the facility.
Right. Would you as a dentist not wear the regular dental garb? I'm trying to say, what's the dental garb of a dentist?
Most practices today are using scrubs for infection control. Oh. I won't say all. Some will use a conventional shirt, tie, and slacks, or a dress, but they're wearing a disposable garment for infection control. I mean, if you think of it in dentistry, there's saliva, there's blood, there's spray from the high speeds, and those body elements can be a source of infection. I actually, just yesterday, I removed some teeth on a little boy, 6 years of age, and the family wants the teeth.
Mm.
Now, for years, we used to give the baby teeth out. Today, that tooth has blood, it has tissue on it, and is considered hazardous and infectious material. So typically,
so you're not allowed to give out the teeth?
You're not supposed to, no.
So you have to turn your back, and then they steal the tooth from the thing.
Yes. I mean, we are on the radio. What we actually do is we put it in our sterilization system.
Yeah, you disinfect it, right?
Disinfect it, sterilize it, put it in a bag.
Well, I wanted to remember when I swallowed that camera that went through my colon and then came out the other end, and I took it home with me? Well, I guess it's the same kind of thing.
I have
a vivid memory of my baby teeth.
Do you?
In a
mayonnaise jar.
Gerber's baby food jar.
Oh,
that's exactly where they were.
Well, because the teeth were falling out at home.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mom or dad pulled them out.
Yeah. Whereas now, if you took out a couple of my teeth, and I could have them strung around on
it could be a nice piece of jewelry.
Yeah. I could get some pierced earrings.
Absolutely.
For my,
there's no limit to what we could do.
Hey, you could have a scent dental stop in the gift shop.
Yes.
And you could have what? Just an idea.
It's just the image I'm trying to do. My new brand.
Yeah. Just helping. Hey, 7:31 in the morning. Have you ever heard of the Tedeschi Trucks Band?
Tedeschi
Trucks Band.
I've heard of Tedeschi Food Stores of the same name.
Isn't it the same spelling?
Yes.
Yeah. Right?
Well, guess what? I think the Tedeschi Food Stores, the daughter of the Tedeschi Food Stores, her name is Susan Tedeschi. Okay, we had her at the in one of our concerts, and she won a Grammy a couple of years back with her husband, who was a member of the Allman Brothers Band. And get this, I thought Tedeschi Trucks Band. I thought, well, it's about a truck. Her husband's name is Derek Trucks, so they got married. So it's Tedeschi Trucks Band. They're a great group. You got to check them out. And they've got a new CD out this.
Well, we're gonna check them out right now, aren't we?
Yeah, okay. Their new album or new CD is called Signs, and this is from that. It's called They Don't Shine. A great rhythm and blues group.
Thank you.
Support for the community programming of WSKB is provided by Bay State Dental. Comprehensive dentistry at 14 convenient locations in Springfield, Chicopee, Longmeadow, West Springfield, Belchertown, East Longmeadow, Ludlow, Northampton, Greenfield, and Wilbraham, as well as 29 Broad Street in Westfield. Bay State Dental makes it a priority to help you achieve and maintain the healthy smile you deserve. On the web at baystatedental.com.
We thank the generosity of our underwriters. For more information, please contact the Westfield State Foundation at 413-572-8646. Friday mornings is something different on 89.5 FM. It's JP's Talk About Town.
Community Radio.
89.5 WSKB.
Live from the campus of Westfield State University, this is 89.5 FM, WSKB, Westfield.
Wow, it's Tuesday morning, and Tina Gorman just called in and wanted to let everybody know that Senior Center will be closing at 1 o'clock because the schools are dismissing early today.
Oh.
They will still have lunch at noon, and their brown bag program is still on for today. So, seniors, you could still go there. The morning programs will still be ongoing. All morning programs will be okay.
Right.
Lunch at noon. And then they're going to send you home to hunker down because this afternoon's drive is going to be pretty nasty. Heavy snow.
Heavy snow. So be safe out there.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah.
So do you want me to comment on the phone call during the break?
No. Did Tina want you to talk about that right now?
Actually,
The caller said that this is that one Tina of the most Grum. Important things coming out of my mouth this morning. So I'll address it. The question is, what is a dental crown? Why is it needed? How is it done? So, in general, every tooth in the human body has five surfaces, a top, a front, a back, and two sides. As a general rule, once a tooth that has five surfaces has been damaged or there's a large restoration or filling on it that takes up more than three surfaces, so basically more than 60% of the tooth is artificial or has been broken.
Mm.
It's a general good idea to consider putting a crown on the tooth. And what the crown is the dentist reduces your tooth by about 2 millimeters. The reason for the reduction is the crown is going to be bonded or cemented directly over your existing tooth. So as a general rule, when 60% of the tooth is missing, the crown is probably a better restoration. Some of the
rather than filling,
Correct.
Ah.
When you fill a tooth and more than 60% of the tooth is filled, if you bite the wrong way, if you hit it the wrong way, there's a chance that it will fracture and break and ultimately could mean the loss of the tooth or more expensive procedures such as root canals, gum surgeries, et cetera, et cetera. Wasn't As it? A general rule, the crowns can cost, in this particular area, anywhere from about $750 all the way up to $2,000.
Why would it cost? Why do they cost more? What's a $2,500 or one?
Well, first of all, it allows me to make more money. But if I got right down to it, the dental plans... Yeah. When you have a crown, and most consumers or patients don't understand it, the crown can be made out of plastic, it can be made out of metal, it can be made out of precious metal, it can be made out of semi-precious metal, it can be made out of acrylic, it can be made out of porcelain. For example, the other day I did an all-gold crown, which is rare, but this gentleman wanted an all-gold crown.
Was he a rapper?
It was a... A cosmetic thing.
No, in this particular case, and I think most dentists would agree, if you eliminated the cosmetics, gold lasts the longest. You have the least amount of problems with it. It's the most biocompatible. Unfortunately,
really?
Most people don't like a gold crown in their mouth because of the way it looks.
Yeah.
But that gold crown, just the laboratory fee alone, to have an all yellow gold high precious metal crown probably cost me almost $850.
Isn't gold $1,200 an ounce right now?
So the point is the insurance company allows the dentist to use the material and technique that they think is most appropriate, but there's a different fee schedule for these materials.
Mm.
For example, if I made your crown out of nickel, it might cost me $75 to make. Now, do you know as a consumer whether I use nickel, silver, or gold? You probably don't.
No.
And
well, unless I had to ask for it. Now
right.
I'll know.
Right.
What's
so
that crown made of?
So what the question comes in is, why is there a different fee? There's a different fee associated with material. Personally, in my opinion, and it's just my opinion, you should pay for the expertise, the knowledge, and the skills, not necessarily the material. Each time you put a material in, you're more of a laborer than a professional. Hopefully, the dentist that is providing your care will explain to you the materials, the options, and the cost associated. Where a healthcare professional has a problem is if Mr. and Mrs. Smith come in and say, I want an all non-precious material. And if it has 10 or 15% nickel in it, doesn't matter. That's what I want because it's less expensive. Well, you're put in a difficult position because as a healthcare provider, you should be using the best material and the best technique.
Mm-hmm.
But sometimes there's a cost. The consumer is looking at their pocketbook, their wallet, and saying to themselves, I can afford $700, but I can't afford $2,000.
Sure.
So getting back to the caller's question, generally the crowns are completed in two visits. Most offices that are using digital technology, the crowns can be milled and 3D printed right on your same visit. Right now, about 3% of the offices in the United States have that technology.
Mm-hmm.
At Ascent Dental, we've had it.
My office, Montgomery Dental, has it as well.
And you're finding it more and more.
But that's a temporary. They put it's a full yo.
Right.
Yeah.
So the newer digital computers and processors, they can make you the permanent restoration, and it can be milled right then and there. So
now,
some of the older versions allowed you to immediately make a temporary, but Mr. and Mrs. Smith couldn't keep that restoration.
Wait a minute, hold on. I have a question on mine, because I did this. I went through this process in September.
Oh, you did?
So the one that was the permanent one, you put in as a temporary to make sure the fit check and things like that. That's why it goes in as a second visit, right?
And there were other reasons. Sometimes the patient has an infection. Sometimes the dentist isn't sure that the tooth may need a root canal down the road, or they've had a root canal and they want to make sure that root canal is going to be successful.
Mm.
So from a clinical standpoint, sometimes that dentist is using their judgment and saying, even though I could technically put your final crown on in that same appointment, we're going to hold off for a couple of days to a week to make sure there's no issues.
Once well, to see what it feels like, because right. maybe your bite is a little off. Right. Your tooth might be perfect, but your the I often found that I've had a crown or two that was put in that was a little too high than it should have been, and right. the doctor in the second visit said, "Well, let's reduce it."
Right, and what you're looking at when we talked about corporations, and when Jay talked about quality controls and. When you're doing these digital restorations, that computer has tolerances that no human being could possibly come up with.
Mm.
As a general rule, it can mill these restorations to within 25 microns or less, which yeah. means it's a virtually a perfect seal. No human could determine whether the crown that they're making by hand has that kind of tolerance. And this is the ability of technology, machinery, software
yeah.
to come up with treatments and restorations that at this point no human being could do.
So here's a question for you. Then the crown has to not look like a crown in your mouth. So your all teeth are different colors, right? And not hopefully not in the same mouth, but
yes.
do you know what I'm saying?
Yes. That is, they have so different hues, different chromos, different values. Those are the three criteria to come up with the most aesthetic restoration.
So how does the crown color, how do you get
the
that?
Blocks that we're personally purchasing, the block that's being 3D printed or milled, come in a variety of different hues, chromas, shades. And values or shades, and that block has a variety in one block. So the tooth doesn't look just chalky. So I bought the first CEREC unit in the early 90s.
What do you call that?
It's called CEREC, Ceramic Aesthetic Restorations is the acronym. But the bottom line is back in the early 90s, it looked like a block. There was very little cosmetics.
Yeah.
It was cool technology, but it didn't compare. Today, it's very, very difficult to compete with this kind of technology. The mm-hmm. reason only 3-4% of the dental population have it is the machinery is in the hundreds of thousands of dollars. So some dentists just buy the camera and they send the image out to a commercial lab. Some dentists like myself have the commercial lab where I can mill it right at my facility and I have the camera. So these are, I'm not saying one's better than another,
right.
but as a consumer, the more educated and more knowledgeable you are about the technology, it's like anything.
So the dentist says to me, okay, you need a crown. Oh, I don't want a crown. Well, you've got to have a crown. What's my alternative if I don't have a crown?
One alternative is a bonded filling, and that bonded filling is really just a soft bis GMA plastic that we mold into the tooth and cure. It's not as strong as a crown. It will stain. It will not last as long as a crown. But from a cost standpoint, you're probably looking at about $130 to $385
mm-hmm.
for a bonded restoration or filling compared to a crown that could be anywhere from $800 to $2,000.
Uh-huh.
So
would another alternative be, okay, you've lost a goodly portion of your tooth. Therefore, we'll take the tooth out.
Yes, and that happens in most dental offices on a daily basis. And I would say the practitioner that you believe, like, and trust in will tell you that in the short term, the extraction purely from a monetary standpoint is less expensive. The average extraction, depending on the type of tooth and location, $195 to $550.
Mm-hmm.
The reason for the range, if it's fully impacted in the bone, if you have to surgically remove it, place grafting material in it, et cetera, et cetera. But without getting off the point, the extraction, now how do you replace the tooth?
Ah, yeah,
so
yeah, you still have a hole there,
tooth,
yeah.
You're going to replace the tooth with either a fixed bridge, a removable bridge, or a dental implant, and the cost of any of those three procedures would be more expensive than if you just put the crown on the tooth.
So,
for the people who are saying, you know, from a cost standpoint, Kevin, just take the damn tooth out. And I go, if you're not going to replace it, and you understand the consequences of not replacing
yeah,
it.
Yeah, what happens then? You've got a hole in your mouth.
You have a hole in your mouth, which means your other teeth are going to drift and shift, which means those teeth are going to be compromised. It's not going to happen overnight. As a general rule, a tooth drifts or shifts a couple of tenths of a millimeter every few months. Oh. Obviously, the older we are and the poorer the bone quality, the more the teeth drift and shift. The healthier you are, the younger you are, the better the bone quality, the slower the teeth.
Well, Kev, I was going to ask you then, you know, the decision that I have to make to crown or not to crown may be based on my age, right?
Absolutely.
And if I'm 75 years old and... I've got another 30 years of life. Let's hope I have another 30 years of life. Maybe I don't. But okay, so if somebody comes in at 80, the decision to crown or not to crown, tooth out.
What I would tell the listeners is remember that a removal of a tooth is a surgical procedure. So in my close to 37 years of treatment, sometimes an extraction in an older person that mentions like you, I'm 80, I'm 75.
What does it matter? Yeah.
And I'm saying, well, why subject yourself to a more evasive treatment? Typically, someone 75 is on a daily aspirin, 81 milligrams.
Yeah.
They're on Coumadin, warfarin. They're on anticoagulant medications. And I'm going, why do I want to traumatize Mr. and Mrs. Smith with a surgical procedure when I can do a non-surgical procedure? You look at it from a cost standpoint, but an age standpoint, but when you're dealing with an older population, it may be less invasive and easier and less traumatic to do a crown rather than the extraction.
Sure.
And you just have to explain to Mr. and Mrs. Smith so that they fully understand the aspects from both sides of the equation. Sometimes people look at me and they go, all this fancy equipment, I don't know if I want to spend that kind of money. Pull it out. And I go, you understand, this is a traumatic experience.
Oh, yeah.
Their heart rate's going to go up. Their blood pressure's going to go up.
And the teeth are going to shift. And then it's going to cause more problems down the line.
Right. And if you're not going to replace it purely from a monetary standpoint, it is a less expensive procedure. Now you just got to weigh the health risk. And I always tell patients, if you can pick a non-surgical approach first, I would advise most people to consider non-surgery before surgery.
Yes. Oh, great. You know, you cover that very well. Thank you, doctor.
It's almost like I know what I'm talking about.
I do. I'm telling you. Hey, Valentine's Day is coming up, so I have to play a Valentine's Day song. If you, I just thought, oh God, what? I'm not going to play. What's the Valentine? My funny Valentine is always. So I said, well, what's a Valentine expression? Be my love. Then I thought, there was that Mario Lanza hit. Then I said, I can't play Mario Lanza. Let me play Andrea Bocelli. So this is Be My Love, the Mario Lanza hit from the movie The Toast of New Orleans that was a big, big hit for Mario Lanza in the 50s, reinterpreted by Andrea Bocelli.
Hand in hand, We'll find love's promised land. There'll be no one but you for me. Eternally. If you
Support for the community programming of WSKB is provided by Commercial Distributing Company of Westfield. Now in its third generation of family ownership, Commercial is one of the premier beverage distributors of Western Massachusetts. The Plasek family and the staff of Commercial Distributing wishes you good times throughout the year and urges you to drink responsibly. Underwriting for community radio is provided by the YMCA of Greater Westfield. Every day, the YMCA strengthens the community through programs and services focused on youth development, healthy living, and social responsibility. For all the Y's many programs and services, visit us on the web at www.westfieldymca.org. The YMCA, 67 Court Street in downtown Westfield. We're more than a gym. We're a cause. We thank the generosity of our underwriters. For more information, please contact the Westfield State Foundation at 413-572-8646.
Wednesday mornings from 6 till 8, it's Tina Gorman with Wake Up Wednesday.
Community Radio,
89.5 WSKB.
Live from the campus of Westfield State University, this is 89.5 FM WSKB Westfield.
Wow, it's Tuesday morning, and we are winding up a great show, February 12th, 2019. Happy Valentine's Day in 2 days. Hey, Dr. Kevin Coughlin from Ascent Dental Care in East Longmeadow. Hey, doctor, have you handled, what do you do for Valentine's Day? Are you a romantic?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
You know, I'll tell you a true story.
Yeah.
My wife just turned 58 years old this week.
Oh, my God, yeah.
And I asked her what she wanted.
Yeah,
she
what did
said,
she say?
You know what I really want?
Yeah.
I want some McDonald's fries. So I said, are you sure? Would you want the super size? She goes, I would just like some large fries. So her and I went to Cape Cod. Our daughters met us. We went with two other couples. I swung into the drive-thru, got her a large fries. A beautiful card. We had a lot of laughs, and we had a great weekend. So in my opinion, as my wife said to me, she goes, how easy am I? Don't
my.
Take that the wrong way.
Yeah, no. Okay.
How easy am I?
And
I said, don't take it the wrong way.
Yeah.
So
I met your wife. She seems like she's a pretty easygoing lady.
Yeah, she's lovely.
She's wonderful. We just 32 years, been very lucky.
Wow.
I could not do anything close to what I do if I didn't have her support.
What's her name?
Karen. And we met in my dental office.
She opened her mouth and smiled.
She smiled, yes.
And then, yes. Do you take care of her teeth?
I do, yes.
You really do?
Yes, I do.
Oh, my God.
Yes.
And are there any
along
arguments
with
about
200 family members.
Oh,
okay.
Oh yeah. Oh, they're
which
all coming
why
in.
Which is I'm still working.
Ah.
Okay.
Yeah. Peter, how about you? What are you doing for Valentine's Day?
I don't have firm plans yet, but we'll see.
Yeah, yeah.
There's an anti-Valentine's Day party at MGM in the sports bar.
Really?
Yeah.
So what does that mean? That you go there if you don't like, you're free and footloose and fancy free?
Yeah.
Or you just don't like love?
Yeah, well, anti-Valentine's Day. You don't believe in the whole hype for Valentine's Day.
Oh, I see. It was always when in elementary school, I love the idea of making a little box that you put the cards in and you make cards for every... Oh, I love that. Oh, more than anything in the world. And now,
it's another time to just take a minute and say, we're pretty lucky.
Yeah.
If you have someone you care about, it's just something small. So I don't do gifts, large gifts.
No.
It's just
James has broken his foot, so he will be recovering from, he's having surgery tomorrow. Good luck, my friend.
Sign his cast.
Yeah, there. I will sign his cast, and I will make him a scone or two. Maybe some, I've got a new recipe for onion soup. I know, a French onion soup, so... I might be trying that, you know. But hey, Doc.
Hey, thank you once again. I appreciate the invite.
Is where you're found.
Oh yeah. Ascent Dental Care.
Yeah.
We have two offices in East Longmeadow, an office in Longmeadow, and soon to have several more offices.
Mm-hmm.
I'm excited. Things are going well. Once again, I appreciate the invitation. I enjoyed the calls. I hope the listeners enjoyed. Be safe out there in the snow, and I look forward to next month.
I look forward to always having you here. Thank you, my friend. Hey, it's 7:59.
Are you playing the game or no?
No, we're not going to play the game because we don't have time unless you'd like to play the game, Ken.
I'll let you play the game.
Oh. Oh, yeah. Okay. Got it.
Somebody messed with it again. Grab Mike, too.
All right. Kevin is on his way to East Longmeadow, and we've got Ken Stomsky here. We're going to play his
name. Come on over, Kath.
Kathleen Palmer, come right over here. She's dressed in a leopard outfit today. You look like gold. You were doing Goldfinger or something. Really, you look beautiful. Come on, sit down there. Question number one. Name something you'd like to do all day long without feeling any guilt.
Read a book.
Yeah.
Can I say that on the radio?
Eat chocolate.
Eat chocolate. Name something I'd like to do all day long without feeling any guilt.
Sleep.
Ooh, that's a good one. I'm going with sleep. Yeah. No, you're going with sleep. All right, I'm going to go with watch QVC. Yeah. That sounds.
Really?
Yeah,
I know.
I don't know. All right. Sleep and relax is 39% of 100. Eat 14. Read is 3. Shop. Oh, we forgot about
QVC.
Shop.
That's QVC.
Yeah, there we are. Well, I never buy anything, incidentally. Watch TV and movies is 7. All right. So, QVC. All right. What's the best thing to... Who won that one?
You guys all did.
I did.
Sleep, yeah.
Sleep. You did, Ken. What's the best thing to do if your teenager starts using curse words, damn it?
Go in the other room.
Yeah. Go in the other room.
Leave.
Ignore.
Yeah.
Attitude adjustment.
Teach them how to properly use them.
Okay, let Dan have a
I was going to say, share the good ones.
Share the good ones. Yeah, I was going to say, swear back.
Yeah.
All right.
Why did we ask you to?
So this is so lame. Talk to them. Clean their mouth out with soap. 23 out of the 100.
How long ago was that done?
I was going to say the soap.
That's attitude adjustment.
Yeah, really. I don't think these people have children.
Spank or pop them?
That's also attitude.
Pop them?
Like this. Ping.
I don't think that's what pop means.
Oh, my God. Ground.
I'm trying to
What's this? Ground them. Oh, ground them. I was thinking of after.
like a meat grinder?
Put your hand in here. Let's make a little. Find them. Oh, my God.
Find them?
Yeah. Find them. My God.
Well, it's your money.
Yeah. Tape their mouth shut. Oh, my God.
How long ago was this done, Bob?
It's got to be what?
A couple of years old.
All
right.
Has to be, because today's teenagers, that's every other word out of their
mouth. Kathleen, you won that round.
Yeah.
Name an occupation you'd hate for your neighbors upstairs to have.
Drummer.
Occupation.
A drummer.
Jazz tap dancer.
A drummer and a tap dancer.
Lawyer, just because we don't need lawyers.
Come on now.
There you are.
Sex trafficking.
That's awful. That's awful.
But it's a good one.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, I wouldn't want that upstairs.
Oh, I've got one. Child care.
You wouldn't want a child care.
Well, no, because I wouldn't want all these babies and kids running around all day upstairs.
Exactly. That's why I picked
drug dealer make the list?
Yeah, I'm going to say drug dealer. Yeah, I would not want that. I actually had that in New York City. I heard them plotting and everything. The guy got sent up on the river, and the FBI came and took him away. Honest to God. Really. Musician and singer is number one. Mm-hmm. Dancer, tap dancer is number two. Peter.
I got the number one and number two.
Disc jockey. Ah, that's an interesting one. What would a disc jockey be doing?
No wonder why my neighbors hate me.
This goes along with the drug dealer. Mm. Number four is police officer. Why wouldn't you want a police officer?
Because they could come in all kinds of different shifts.
Yeah, but wouldn't you feel safer?
I feel much safer.
It depends on what you're doing.
When
you have little children.
If you are the drug dealer, you don't want your neighbor to be a police officer.
No. Okay. Here's the final question.
Thank God.
Name a part of the body where men start to grow hair about the same time they're losing it on their heads.
Nose.
Ears.
Back.
That's number one and number two.
Back.
Three.
Kathleen.
Eyebrows. I don't know.
Busted sweat into eyebrows.
A little part in the middle.
Coming on your ears.
I don't know.
Let's see. I have hair growing. No, I don't
I don't want to hear
it. No. I don't have any hair anywhere. I look like a Ken doll. The older you get, everything kind of like falls off. So how about on the palms of your hands?
I think something else does that.
All right.
I don't know.
Let's go with the answers now, Bob.
All right. Ears is number 43 people. Back is number two. Chest is number 12. And nose. Oh, those damn nose hairs. Oh, God. Please, God.
Nose hairs, though.
Yeah, huh?
Yeah, they grow real fast. Yeah, they
start dangling out a little bit more.
Hey, yeah. Have you ever known somebody who had, you just want to say, would you take care of your nose hairs? You know, honest to God, everybody look in the mirror today and take care of it. There's nothing worse. It's like a bad toupee. You just sort of kind of stare at it.
8:05 and we're down here all day.
The winner is Kathleen Palmer.
Oh, dear God, no.
Yeah.
She won again.
She wins it all.
Yeah. She's going to Ludlow for the weekend. 8:06 in the morning. Hey, everybody, we want to do. I have time. You're going to go into your show, Kenneth?
Yes. It's 8:06.
Yeah, okay. Bob. So I'll save all of my music for next week. And listen, be safe today. It's going to snow and then sleet. Wait until the crusting comes on top of your snow before shoveling it. All right. Then because it's going to sleet and freeze, etc.
All right, Bob, it's time to go out there and volunteer.
And get out there and volunteer. Bye, everyone.
Support for the community programming of WSKB is provided by Bay State Noble.